Hey, what's up traders? Welcome back to Forex Gym for another daily Forex analysis, this one for 26th of March 2020. In this video, I'm going to be analyzing four currency pairs, but before we're going to do that, I'm going to say that if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing. I'm making daily and weekly Forex analysis as well as the knowledge you need to be a better trader.
Starting with the euro against Australian dollar from the daily chart. Yesterday the price came down and almost going to this horizontal line down here. It's around 100 pips apart, but then the price went all the way back up and closed nicely. It looks solid bullish candle, and now we see that the price is bit in a retracement mode towards downside. Obviously the big trend is up. I'm still expecting for this currency to go up. Let's drill down to the 4-hourly chart. So the price came up now and test this high up here, just highlight this high here, and then we have this it let this the inverted hammer, almost a doji candle. But I do not think the price is going to break down, even though that's possible. But I do see that these will have more upside, at least up to these highs, and potentially to break even higher. The second target would be at this weekly pivot. But I do expect this one to go at least up to this 4-hourly high. Let's have a look at the hourly chart. So what I'm waiting for this to set up towards long side. I want to see this one to come down for another 20 to 25 pips where that low is. Let's have a look. So it's 83, it's around 83.70-75 zone. Then I'll be looking to get onto the long side. Of course, if it's gonna set up now, we see. Okay, now it's actually triggering this one. I placed normally this one around 15 pips, where the 15 pips close to the my entry is gonna be. Actually, I can record this if it's gonna push it down more for another 10-15 pips, and if it sets up. So it needs to come down around where this 4-hourly S1 is. Then I will be looking if it gives me potential to get onto the long side. But I see that it's not going to happen another half an hour for my setup. I generally use a 15-minute chart to get onto the as of the entries. And then if it sets up, then I will be looking to get onto the long. For the stopwise, we would be looking, let's calculate, so it's 83.75, 65. You would be looking a good solid 30 pip stop, but then we got the target up to this 86.90 zone, which is quite far away actually. So the risk reward is pretty good. So you can use 30 pips or even more. Or the one thing you can do, you can have even a closer target. This could be also a good one, 5600 almost. We have this kind of high up here, but it's not very good. I would personally wait to the main high is up here, which is the 86.90 zone. We see now the price is going down. So maybe by the time I got this video uploaded, this opportunity will be gone. I try to get this one up on the YouTube as soon as I can. Let me just bring this one down, and so this is it. I might even film the live when I'm taking the trade. So let's see how, if it's gonna set it up. We continue with the US dollar against Canadian dollar. Yesterday we had this nice bearish strong candle. It came down and it closed nicely, and now we see that the price is a bit hesitant. But I do see that it's gonna have a more follow through towards downside. The downside pressure looks strong, and it has this very mild retracement toward upside. So I'm waiting for this one to have another push to this 1-hourly, this high here. We can see that one here. I got in my mark and I'm waiting to get a signal, which is at 142.55, around 142.55. So another 15 pips, 15 to 20 pips away. So it's not that far. Price might go even a bit further to this. You might want to test this daily pivots. However, I don't like to take a trade just purely based on the daily pivot or just one evidence. Like if I had only this 1 hourly high, then I will be a bit more reluctant if I'm gonna take the trade or not. But we have also these highs, we got this spike high here, and also we got 4 hourly R1 if we go to the short time frames near to this 4 hourly R1. So we got few evidence there that the price might want to go down, and also of course the 4 hourly and 1 hourly trend looks down, so that's the main one, the trend of course. And then you look for the other evidence that the price wants to stop there, used as a resistance, and turn around and continue to a trend direction. So now for this one, the stop wise, if we get into let's say it's 142, let's call it 142.60 zone, you need to use, you can get away with a 15-20 pips stop. And for the target, let's have a look what we can use. We can use the certainly there's a daily S1, or we can 41.60 down here. We can use this daily low down here, that's one, because daily S1 is at 141.13, that's a bit further down. We can use this one as a first target, and the second target with this daily S1. But it does look like they won't even have more follow through towards the downside, but that's not sure yet because the big trend is still on the upside. But we get this price gives some clues when it might want to change the trend right direction. Next currency we've got US dollar against Japanese yen, starting with a daily chart. This pair is in a chopping mode right now. If we go to the 4 hourly chart, we see that when the price came up, it is going up and down all over the place. And I did mention that yesterday as well, it makes very marginal new highs. And also yesterday it made it could not make the marginal new high, just about, but it could not take out these high here. So we see that retracement, the price going down. But we have this tight range, the price is just going sideways, doesn't really do much. Even though the big trend is up, I do want to see this one too. I can see this one going a bit more down, at least down to maybe one of these lows. The first low could be at 110.26, and if the price breaks that one, would be one down at this low at 109.50 zone. So I do see that the price might want to come down even and take out this this low here. There might be a lot of orders down here, so the buyers and sellers are at equal, so that's why the price is chopping around and doesn't do much at the moment. So I do want to see this one to have a bit more retracement up before I can get onto the short side. But for now it's kind of coming down slowly, but hopefully it gives me a chance to get onto the short side if it pushes higher. But now we see that the price is not really, so now it's getting away from the from this 1100 area, which is now 33 pips away. So I do want to see this one to come up, and then I will begin on to the short side. So the reason why I'm looking for this area as of the to get on to for the entry is, let's have a look, this one is, we got this high here, and also this near to this close to this spike low down here, and we also have this daily pivot. And if we go to the 4 hourly chart, this is same as, let me just go back, this is also the same as this spike high here on 4 hourly chart. So it's decent enough resistance, not very strong, but because the price looking fairly weak. It does not really take as much, but I don't think now this price will go higher. We can see that the price is coming down, but then anything is possible. It's a probability game. As of the for the stop losses, if we get on to the 1,100, for the stop loss you need 15 to 20 pips for the max, and for the for the target we would be looking at 1,100. The target is at 110.26 zone. As of the first one, you can take the half, you can split the position, take the half off, and then run the remaining positions to down to at 109.50 zone, or even take the one third off and split it into three, depending what size you put in for the position, and you can run it another one to the weekly pivot, which is another 50 pips away. Lastly, we got New Zealand dollar against US dollar. The New Zealand dollar is recovering a bit, though it is still on a retracement mode. If we look at this daily chart, the trend is still strongly down. Let's go drill down to the shorter time frames. I do see this one to push a little bit higher to these 4 hourly highs at 58.70 zone, 75 zone, up to these 4 hourly highs here. So that's why I'm looking. I want to see a little bit retracement on this one, probably another 10 pips. So for the entry, I'm looking for it's 58.20 zone, 58.20 zone, 22 around this area. If the price lets me to do that, so it came up to these 1 hourly highs. Let's go closer. So the price came up to these highs and now kind of having a mild retracement, and I want to see this one to come down to these near to these lows. And we also have these highs here and a spike. There is a decent enough support to send it to towards upside to 4 hourly highs, which is around, we can also target this daily R1, which is almost at the same level, about 10 pips apart. So 58.75 zone as a target would be good. So it gives you about 35 to 40 pips profit. So if you use it, a tight stop, let's say we get, let's for simplicity call it 58.20, and for the stop the good one about 12 pips. We can use 12 pip stops, maybe 15 would be for the max. And if you run it to at 58.75 zone, that gives about just over 1 to 3 risk reward, which is still very good risk rewards on it. Anything more than a 1 to 2 is good, depending on your preference and on your strategy. I personally use 1 to 3. I want to have the 1 to 3 risk reward or higher.
Thank you guys for watching. This was Daily Forex Analysis for 26th of March, 2020. If you find this video helpful, please give it a like, share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. I'm making daily and weekly forex analysis, as well as videos about the knowledge you need to be a better trader. Have a great day, and I will see you guys in my next video.